Hi, I am Dr. Girish Jethwa from Jethwa Eye Hospital, Anand, India. My presentation is on aquestion optimization of IRPIMR calculation. Why we should optimize aquestion of IOL power? Today, cataract surgery is a refractive surgery, so patients' expectations are higher and precision in IOL power calculation is must. Even after doing careful calculation and good surgery, patient may end up with some residual power. If a surgeon uses optical biometry and modern techniques but does not optimize, he may be off one diopter on myopic or hypermetropic side. Here there is comparison between the optimized and non-optimized A constant. You can see that there is a fourfold improvement in post-operative targeted refraction when we optimize A constant. There could be errors in biometry, keratometer, keratometric index, selection of formula, A constants, and surgical factors. When we do the biometry, non-optical biometry, there are more chances of error. Optical biometers have good standardization and measurements which are precise and consistent between the different instruments, so it is more reliable. We know that the cornea is not a sphere. It is steeper in the center than the periphery. So what happens that the different instruments measures the different area of the cornea, giving the different results. American optical keratometer, which is 100 year old, it measures 2 points 3.2 apart on a 44 diopter cornea. IOL Master, which is automated keratometer, uses a width of 2.5 millimeter. The narrower width will produce a value of 0.37 diopter higher on the same eye because the curvature is steeper there. Whereas the Hex Street Lenstar uses still smaller area, 1.8 to 2.2 millimeter, it's measuring closer to the center of the cornea, so its measurement of the same cornea will be even steeper. Please do not mix different keratometers. IOL Master manufacturer's A constant is good with IOL Master's K only, not manual K or other instrument's K. Keratometric index has also effect on IOL power calculation. Different refractive index is there in different manufacturers. In United States, it is 1.3375. In Europe, it is 1.336 or 1.332. As a result, 7.5 mm radius of corneal curvature in the United States, it is 45 diopter. In England, the same eye would measure as 44.8 diopter, and in Germany, it will go to 45 diopter. You can see that there is a facility of changing the keratometric index in IOL Master 700 and some other machines also. This is a printout of power calculation where the N is a number of refractive index setup done. You can set up 1.336, 1.332 or 1.3375 as per your choice. A constant changes when the surgical factors are changed. Any surgical steps that may affect final effective lens position of IOL, capsulosis size, centration, incision size, its position, and inadequate OVD removal can affect A constant. Even someone has said that change in post-operative steroids dose may also affect the scarring and may also change the A constant. Now, let us see how many variables are there in A constant calculations. It is seen in this graph that more number of variables will give a better A constant. So Barrett has more variables and it can give a better results. Here there is comparison of preoperative measurable variables in different IOL formula. You can see here that in Barrett Universal 2 and Hill RBF has more variables, so it is more precise in A constant optimization. According to Holaday, when new lenses come out, manufacturers don't recalculate the constant for new lenses. They just transfer the constant from similar existing IOL. As for example, Technis 1 and Technis Eyhans has same A constant. Change in IOL geometry may change A constant. Dr. Hill says that A constant supplied by the lens manufacturer are not considered definitive. If you enter numbers provided by the lens manufacturer into the IOL master, for example, you are likely to end up with hyperopic results in range of half diopter. There are few biometers that provide inbuilt A constant optimization, like Zeiss IOL Master 500, not in IOL Master 700, Nidec AL scan, and Lensstar 900. If you do not have a software inbuilt in your biometer, there are few other options and few websites which will give a facility to calculate your personalized A constant, and here few of are there. First is iolcalculation.com, which is a free website. iolconstant.org, which is also free. Dr. Haggis has ULIB on online calculator, which is also free. Dr. Holaday has Holaday IOL Consultant software, which is a paid one, and Analyze OR technology, which is also a paid, and Zeiss has EQ Workplace, which works for IOL Master 700 and 500, and Callisto I, which is paid website, paid software. Options other than biometers, one more is free one, which is widely used, is Dr. Warren Hill websites, where we have to use minimum 200 eyes data, preferably more than 300. It is a Excel sheet which is giving a good results. We have to enter the data and we have to email it to the website, and they calculate the personalized A constant and send back. Whereas Dr. Saurabh Soni has a free Excel sheet where you enter the data and you can get a personalized A constant instantly shown, and preferably we should enter more than 50 eyes data. Now let us see how to go ahead for calculating personalized A constant. You will need to collect the data of at least 200 patients, same model of the IOL should be used, uncomplicated surgery, good quality of preoperative measurements, total K is preferable, having a facility of calculating posterior corneal curvature, 4 to 10 week postoperative refraction should be there, and results should be better than 6-9 or more. Site and size of incision should be same, preferably temporal, power of implanted IOL, selected expected and target refraction should be entered in the formula. We should avoid bad quality measurements, abnormal ocular dimensions, means very high hypermetropia, very high myopia, and multiple surgeries should be avoided. No toric IOL or no extended depth of focus IOLs. My personalization of Technis IHANS on Dr. Saurabh Soni Excel sheet is, whereas the company is giving 119.30 and my A constant is 119.33. This was calculated when I had 120 patients. Whereas in the same hour, personalization of IHANS lens, Technis IHANS lens by Dr. Hill's website, the company's one is 119.3, whereas I got 119.32. So it is more or less same in Dr. Soni and Dr. Hill results. What are advantages after optimization? Personalizing constants can make a significant difference, but it does require time and effort. But still, once you do it, results will fall within the half adapter. This is helpful when we are dealing with a short eye, which can make a great change in the results. But how long we should continue this? We should understand that this is not a one-time exercise, but such customization or optimization is an ongoing process, and that is a must when you change the surgical technique, when you change one of your instruments. Thank you for your attention. Thank you.